Who is this Lewis that works for you?
Ha! A bit of an odd fish, isn't he? Came to me a few years past.
He's very solemn.
But always so polite. And he has many other talents.
Who am I looking for?
Chester Swinebourne. A copper by day and snitch by night. Remove him from the pack, and you cut Starrick's ties to the police force.
Must be good at what he does to keep the charade going for so long.
He is indeed, dear boy. Yeah!
All these bobbies give me goose flesh.
Welcome to Scotland Yard. excellent work. Do come find me at the Alhambra. I have more amusements planned for us.
Walk on, girl. Steady on. Keep moving.
This way, my dear. I've something to show you.
Oh. Saw a murder. Mm-hmm. Mel's going 19 to the
dozen. Where are we going?
Just seen someone get killed.
One of Starrick's workshops, where they build weapons for his army. When the world is full of nasty things, we must tear those things apart. Like Starrick built a world.
That's a girl. Funk in you.
You must see the potential, dear Jacob. This workshop is one of Starrick's. Set the dynamite and let's blow it to atoms. Together.
Thank you. That's one. There. Thank you. set. And done. Rigged up.
Perfect. Let's put our plan into action. Stand back. Ready?
Wait!
Whatever for?
There are children in there.
Jacob, my dear. Starrick uses child labor to manufacture goods. We must put an end to his production line.
But not like this.
Why not? I can do whatever I damn well please. Soon, you will understand what it is to be free, as I am. Light them up, boys!
No!
What the hell are you doing?
We're not playing games anymore, Roth!
No, we're not.
A gift, sir, from Mr. Rock. You should be warned, Mr. Frye, that when Roth is angry with one, he generally brings suffering to many.
My dearest Jacob, alas, it seems our adventures together have come to a close. Although our time together was brief, it's left a lasting mark. I wish you well in all your future endeavors. Cordially, Maxwell. Postscriptum. I'm putting on a show this evening. All of London will be there. Enclosed, please find your invitation.
West End has certainly come into its own this season.
It has, indeed, sir.
Eliza, is that really you? Aren't these masks marvelous? What a splendid... Oh, Nizzy.
Tell me where I can find one of those elegant pieces for myself.
Ladies and gentlemen, this
entrance
is for masks only.
The bastard.
Thank you.
Everyone ready? Then let's proceed.
Mesdames et messieurs, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Alhambra Music Hall. Tonight, we have, for one night only, a very special performance of Corvus the Trickster. While some of the effects may be visceral and highly disturbing, do not be alarmed, my good people. Fear not. This is a purest form of entertainment. Tonight's performance immortalizes and is for the benefit of a young fellow very near and dear to my heart. Any concerns or complaints may be addressed to him. Jacob, dear boy, tonight is for you.
I'll be serving you this evening, gentlemen.
You're still here, love. Last time, I swear, you nearly poisoned us.
Scene two, stand by!
Let me out! I need to lower the grid for the show!
A big round of applause for this brave, brave man! Our volunteer is about to die for you, Jacob. You lucky people are about to witness this gentleman being fired upon at point-blank range. Our performer will hit several targets placed around his head. Exciting, is it not? Will our honored guest go unharmed? We British are a hardy bunch. Let's put that hardiness to the test.
Excuse me, love. Just looking for the lavatory.
What a thrill!
Thanks.
Do not fret, my friends. It's all part of the show. Please stay with us as we prepare for the next turn. Oh my. Are your principles drifting, dear?
his own. He's compelling me to do this. Oh, sorry.
Your life, Mary.
Figures. Mr. Roth says there's a big surprise in store for everyone.
Where is he?
The search consumes you. Creed forgotten, prey visualized, mouth watering. Found a suitably flat-headed gentleman for this one. You laugh, ladies and gentlemen, but I assure you that is the case. I have no doubt that you could hazard a guess as to what this one concerns, my friends. Our courageous participant hasn't even flinched. Standing a few feet away, our performer expertly throws his knife at the apple, slicing it in two.
Mr. Roth says he'll have me up there, on the stage, before you know.
Will he or won't he? We weren't quite expecting that. How thrilling it is when life surprises us. I am not finished just yet. Stay right where you are, and the show will continue. You prefer tragedy to comedy. I knew you had exquisite taste.
You wash the blood of die! You won't stink me no more! Oh.
For this trick, ladies and gentlemen, we have found a most courageous volunteer.
How marvelous.
Mrs. Culpepper.
With our courageous volunteer in the box, the celebrated illusionist will proceed to saw him in half. Watch as our esteemed guest emerges unharmed. Our skilled illusionist, Sabretooth Jane, is performing this famous trick. She is said to have studied at the feet of the mysterious Torini himself. The saw Miss Jane is using this evening is imported from the ancient city of Codumenal, celebrated for manufacturing the finest steel in the world. Behold the grace with which Jane wields her saw. A diamond in the rough, I dare say. Participating in the show, we've invited him backstage to partake of some refreshment before returning to the audience. Our next turn will begin shortly. Run! Please stay seated as
show
we prepare.
Show yourself! You...
I hope you have enjoyed your evening so far, ladies and gentlemen. I know I have. Now, before our final act, I would like to toast all you brave people who joined us tonight to celebrate life and death. Go on! Toast them! Your move, Jacob, my dear! Burn! 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 Jacob!
Yeah.
the stuff of legends.
Why did you do it? All of it.
What? Snap a baby crow's neck between my thumb and forefinger. Slice to bits the ones you deem innocent. Keep the world in its divine, manic state. For the same reason I do anything. Why not?
I'll never make it out alive. This place from hell to Hackney. Damn this place from hell to Hackney. I'll never make it out alive. Disorder. The sea rises to flood the pubs and extinguish the street lamps. Our city will die. Tupine has failed. Lucy has failed. Brudenell, Elliotson, Pearl. All have gone into the night. It is up to me now. The assassins have brought nature's fury into our homes. Men have become monsters, barreling toward us, teeth out. Our civilization must survive this onslaught. Prevent a return of the Dark Ages. I will start anew.
We
London must be reborn.
The Peace of Eden is under Buckingham Palace. We've got all we need. Let's start planning our infiltration.
Hold on, better to get visual verification. If we're gonna move, we need to be 100% sure. We'll only get one shot before Otso Berg crashes down on us.
Gotta agree with Shaun.
We'll position ourselves near the palace, but we'll wait for you to sync the genetic data before we move.
It's all up to you, Initiate.
You're late. Starrick is making his move. The Peace of Eden is somewhere inside Buckingham Palace.
Let him have it.
I've seen your handiwork across the city. Perhaps you should trust my judgment.
I've been killing Starrick's henchmen. What have you been doing? Let's ask Henry, shall we?
I have been repairing your mistakes. Too much haste is too little speed.
Don't you call father at me.
That's Plato. And I am sorry this doesn't involve anything you can destroy. Father was right, he never approved of your methods!
Father is dead!
Enough! I have just received word from my spies. At the palace ball tonight, Starrick plans to steal the Peace of Eden, and then eliminate all the heads of church and state.
Once more for old time's sake?
And then we're finished.
Agreed. So what's the plan?
Such an unexpected delight to visit you both. What is the news on the street?
Mrs. Disraeli, we have discovered that there is something inside Buckingham Palace that could threaten the...
What my sister's failing to say is that we require entrance into the ball tonight.
Impossible! Even if there were any invitation cards remaining, which there are not, someone of your lowly station...
If that damn fool Gladstone is attending this evening, they can have my card.
Perfect. Then I'll go alone.
Mrs. Disraeli, if you would be kind enough to inform my darling brother of the location of the Gladstone's residence, perhaps he could use his considerable skills to commandeer their cards.
What fun! Did you hear that, Dizzy? We're going to pinch the Gladstone's invitations.
Thank you for volunteering me, sweet sister.
Oh, a pleasure, brother, dearest. Now, Mrs. Disraeli, if you would excuse me, I must visit with the Maharaja. It occurs to me that he may have a second set of plans to a certain vault.